Folks, well, something I've been wanting to do for 28 years for sure is just take a break. And so I am about to take a break, not just from social media, but from everything for a little while. And this is for the millions and millions of people that suffer with anxiety, panic attacks, and PTSD. As many of you know, I'm a survivor of childhood sexual abuse, and I had a complete breakdown in 1992, but I couldn't tell anyone. I couldn't take a break. The business was only 4 years old, so I suffered in silence. I healed in private, and I finally, over the last year, with losing both my parents and within 67 days and dealing with them over the last 18 months with their health and flying back and forth, I realized over the last year I was just drained, tired, because I'd never took a break to really kind of dig in and see the true impact that what happened to me as a 9-year-old. So this is for the estimated 42 million survivors just in the USA of childhood sexual abuse. This is for anybody who deals with trauma and anxiety. It's not easy, so I'm sharing this because I don't want anybody else to go as many years as I did before they kind of do what they need to do to truly, truly deal with their anxiety and stuff. And for me, it's just step away for a while. I just want to be a hippie. You know, I'm 64 years old. I got good people at the company who handle things. I'm still going to be involved as little as possible for a little bit. But I just want to get with Carla and her and I just finally just kind of feel the energy of the universe. I want to get closer to my faith in God and the universe and just feel the energy that heals. I've dealt with this for so long where even though I'm healthy, I believe, my physical was good, had a colonoscopy last week, no polyps, heart's good, but I'm going to a cardiologist tomorrow just to make sure that 55 years of anxiety and worry and stress from what happened to me as a child hasn't affected my heart. Even though it feels good, I can work out and all that good stuff. But I just finally want to step away a little bit at 64 and see what it's like. So you're not going to see any posts or anything from me on social media for a while. But when it's done and I'm back and I've had a chance to be a hippie for a little bit and just kind of be one with the earth, I'll let you know how it goes and what it was like. And this is for all those folks out there who don't know what to do, and for the loved ones of people who deal with anxiety and stress and worry. And I'm a worrier. My anxiety is this constant worry and waiting on the other shoe to drop. And I haven't been making the best decisions lately. I can tell over the last year, I've been just so focused on others. And then I got some really close friends that are dealing with cancer, people close to me dealing with cancer and other health issues. And I'm just like, man, it just goes so fast and I don't want to waste it with worry and anxiety constantly. So folks, I hope you will continue to check out what I've posted before and just know that I'll be back. And I thank you for all the support, but I'm just sharing this because I decided in 2012, when I finally started speaking publicly about anxiety and being a survivor of childhood sexual abuse, that I would do whatever I could to help anybody else not suffer in silence, do the things that you need to do with therapy, but also we can still do some incredible things. But I can just tell the time has come after all these years of 64 years old. I just need to go be a hippie with my wife, Carla, and just go let the earth and God just heal all the anxiety and worry. I don't want to spend the rest of my life just with constant anxiety and worry, which I've never dug deep. And what I mean by that, I did the therapy that I needed to understand, but now it's time for me to take some time and just really dig deep and truly, truly free myself from being a survivor of childhood sexual abuse. I know I'll never forget what transpired and what went on, but it doesn't have to have so much impact on my life. So, folks, pray for me, and I'll keep you posted. Love you, and take care. And as I always say, peace, live from Moodyville. Take care.